It's a great event here local in a Washington, D.C. market. And it's a great opportunity for us to get to network with peers and get a chance to see some of the new technologies and new philosophies in trade shows.
So there's really three distinct ideas that I'm going to talk about. One is sort of the philosophy of looking at our attendees as fans. So not marketing to them as much as actually figuring out how do we get them to be advocates and lovers of our brand.
We're very lucky. We have a very large show and we tend to take the lead in a lot of different areas. So for us sometimes it's learning some nuances to enhance what we're doing or maybe learn about something that's successfully happening that maybe we haven't tried.
Let's talk about building relationships in Mexico. You want to bring attendees or exhibitors from Mexico to your show in the US. What do you need to do?
It's very key in Mexico to work with government ministries because it's good to have that seal of approval.
It is a wonderful one-day event where you can come and get a sense of the industry and some of the new and emerging trends that are taking place in the industry.
We created something called Eureka Park just a few years ago. It's the most successful part of the show now. It has the most buzz. It is designated only for startups that meet certain criteria. And we're already over a few hundred exhibits in there. And let me tell you something. The exhibits in there, they get buzz. I mean, it's so gratifying. You know, Walmart has placed orders there. Mark Cuban went around and walked around and invested $1 million on the spot in a company there. And one of our Eureka Park exhibitors just announced that it was being sold for $2 billion.
Plus also an opportunity to network with some of the most impressive people that put on exhibitions worldwide. Well, they're from every walks of life, and that's what's so great. And they come from a variety of backgrounds, and they've been in the industry for many, many years. And so there's a lot of experience, there's a lot of different exposure. There's also really just a lot of different learning about different industries and what's working and what isn't in some different areas. So sometimes what's helpful about this type of event is maybe you're not exactly the same type of industry, but you have similar styles of buyers or similar styles of attendees. And you can take what somebody's already doing and help implement that easily into your organization. I think the great thing about ECEF is that we get to see some of the vendors that we work with throughout the year or learn about some new vendors throughout the year, but we get to do it in a very concise manner whereby which we get some snippets and then we have the ability to go out and ask for more details. And that's always helpful to be able to get kind of a sampling of different things and then be able to go back and dig in a little bit deeper. And I think it's that opportunity to kind of talk more at an executive level. I think it's more of an opportunity to get a high level pitch of what's maybe that product or that offering or what's beneficial. And then the ability for you to set up the time to come back and say, okay, this is something I want to explore a little bit more. Or you go to a peer and say, hey, you're working with this company. How's it going with them? And is it something I should consider and invest some time into. So I think there's a lot of really quick assessment that can take place here.